We're standing here in front of this statue commemorating the smallpox eradication campaign, smallpox being the only disease that the world humanity has eradicated. This WHO-led campaign was the first mass vaccination campaign that brought together countries, experts, and communities. Today, we have 30 vaccines that can prevent many, many diseases. And 154 million lives have been saved in the last 50 years by just 14 of those vaccines. So if you're a new parent, you may have questions about vaccines. We have Dr. Kate O'Brien here with us to answer your questions. Kate, let's start with, parents may have heard, what if we let our child get sick and develop immunity rather than vaccinate them? What is your advice regarding that?
The first thing I want to say is that the vaccines that have been developed that are in our program are vaccines against serious diseases. Sometimes we hear the term natural immunity, and I really want to address this question. Some people think that getting infected is somehow more natural than it is to develop your immunity from a vaccination, and I really want to disavow this. It's the immune system in either circumstance is responding to either a germ or the vaccine itself. What's most important is that exposing children to infections and risking the consequences of serious disease and, in the worst circumstances, death is not what any parent would want to do.
Another question that young parents may have is, if you give a child many vaccines at the same time, you might overwhelm their immune system. What would you say to that?
Children are exposed to, in fact, millions of different microbes in the natural environment around us, in their foods, in the environment, by touching things, in their own bodies. We all have, in fact, more microbes in our body than we do human cells. This is an important way that children's immune systems develop. The issue is how to allow children to develop immunity against those germs that are consequential, that are serious, that cause disease. So the point around the vaccines is, children's immune systems are more than able to respond to multiple vaccines given at the same time and multiple doses that are given over the course of their lifetime. Although we perceive that they're being given, quote, a lot of vaccines, in fact, on a daily basis, children are being exposed and sampling that outside world of those microbes all the time. The immune system is an incredibly powerful system. It's amazing the way that it matures and identifies which is friend and which is foe in the environment. And vaccines are the safest way to actually derive protection for children, adolescents, and adults against the consequential germs.
Can parents maybe stagger the schedule, give a little space? Would that still have the same impact that you're seeking in protecting the child?
Yeah, so this seems like a common sense, logical thing to do. We have studies that tell us in what sequence the vaccines should be given, how many doses should be given, and how far apart they should be. Now, when you mess around with that schedule, there are consequences of doing that. First, it means that children may miss the doses that they should get. Second, it means that they may not get the vaccines at the time when they most need them. We time the schedule so that the protection is developed before the period of time when children are most at risk of the particular disease that the vaccine is protecting against. And third, there are some vaccines that need to be timed relative to other vaccines that are in the schedule. They don't work as well if they're timed incorrectly. So that's the reason why we have pediatricians, scientists, epidemiologists who make the recommendations within each country for what the schedule should be.
So WHO makes a recommendation, right? But who's deciding on what vaccinations a citizen receives?
Countries are the ones who decide on their schedule. What WHO does is, because we're a global recommending body, we pull together experts from around the world. We ask them to look at all of the evidence that is available, and we provide recommendations to countries. They can rely on the aggregated evidence that we've put together so they can also deliberate on what makes most sense for their particular circumstance.
Thank you, Kate. I have additional questions. I'm sure our viewers have additional questions. So we will take this in part two, where we will answer some of your questions on vaccines. Until next time, then, stay safe, stay healthy, and stick with science.